So, dear colleagues, let me open the morning session with the talk of Sergey Bezrodnykh from Federal Research Center, Computer Science and Control, and the title of the talk you see, please, have 40 minutes.
40 minutes. First of all, I would like to express my gratitude for the organizers for the invitation and this opportunity. My talk is devoted to some recent results in solving the problem of analytic continuation of hypergeometric functions in many variables. For the function which is defined by a series with finite domain of convergence, this issue is one of the most important. In our talk, we will draw some parallels with results well known in the theory of the classical Gaussian hypergeometric functions. The Gaussian hypergeometric function is defined by the Taylor series 1 in variable z. A, B, and C are complex parameters. The coefficients of this series are expressed in the form of the Pachgammer symbol or in form of ratio of gamma functions. This function, as it is known, includes many special functions, for example, Legendre functions of first and second kind, many orthogonal polynomials, complete elliptic integrals of first and second kind, and so on. During 19th century, works, famous mathematicians, Jacobi, Riemann, Kummer, built a very beautiful and meaningful theory of this function. The beginning of the theory of multivariate hypergeometric functions dates back to the end of the 19th century. At this time, Paul Appel and Giuseppe Lauricella introduced the first representatives of such functions and applied these functions to mechanics. This new class of function attracted quite a lot of interest, and so the natural question arose of what definition should be given to general hypergeometric function of n variables. The answer to this question was given by German mathematician Gorn. He proposed to put into the base the property of coefficients of classical Gaussian hypergeometric function. For this function, the ratio of two successive coefficients is a simple rational function of the index k. According to Gorn's approach, n multiple series should be called hypergeometric if any two neighboring coefficients of this series, if ratio of two neighboring coefficients is some rational function of the indexes k1, etc., kn. That is, the relation 3 holds where p and q are some polynomials. This property of coefficients imply some interesting properties. We remind that the Gaussian hypergeometric function satisfy the differential equation 4, which is a Fuchs-type equation with three singular points, 0, unit, and infinity. At the same time, the Horn hypergeometric series is function in n variables. It satisfies the system of partial differential equations 5, where q of theta and p of theta are differential operators, which are obtained by satisfying the components of the vector theta into the polynomials q and pi, which was presented at the previous transparency. These polynomials, p and q. The next question is whether it is possible, starting from this property 3, to find some explicit formulas for these coefficients. That is, whether it is possible to write some formulas, some simple formulas like this, known for the classical hypergeometric function. The answer to this question gives the Urey-Sata theorem. According to this assertion, coefficients of arbitrary Horn's series can be represented as the product 6, as a product mainly contains product of gamma functions, some complex factor t to the kth power, and the rational function r of k. Gamma first, etc., gamma m is complex parameters. These coefficients, and hence the property of the Horn series, mainly determined by the integer matrix L that represents here. Next, we will consider some particular case of these coefficients and Horn series, but this particular case do not essentially confine the generality of our considerations. Namely, we prescribe some normalization conditions and will consider the series 7. It differs from the previous coefficient 6 by the presence of the factorial k. That is, the matrix of L considers some unit submatrix. Besides, we suppose that the conditions 8 hold. These conditions guarantee that the series 7 has a finite domain of convergence. So we start to find analytic continuation of formulas for the series 7. It should be said that the importance of this statement of the problem was emphasized during the 20th century in the works of well-known specialists and well-known mathematics. For example, Ofer Day, some Japanese mathematicians, Amota, Gilfand and his scientific school. Pierre Deligne have considered similar questions when he studied a problem of monodromy for hypergeometric functions. We mean that we will find analytic continuation formulas via some exponentially convergent series, not via some integrals, because the exponentially convergent series makes it possible to very effectively compute this function and find its asymptotics and give other constructions for this function. We will take advantage of the known results from the theory of Gaussian hypergeometric function. We remind that this function satisfies the hypergeometric equation 9 with three singular points. Near every singular point, one can find so-called canonical solutions. These functions are known as the Kummers solutions for the hypergeometric equation. Two solutions converge near the origin in the unit circle with the center in the origin. Two solutions converge in the unit circle centered in the unit, and two solutions converge outside the unit disk. So the next step is we can find analytic continuation of Gaussian hypergeometric function in the form of linear combination 13 with explicitly written coefficients. The coefficients are expressed in terms of gamma function. Here, simple expressions for these coefficients. Well-known monographs Bateman RD and others contain the full range of these formulas. Of course, for multiple hypergeometric functions, the problem is much more difficult. It is the problem of finding solutions to the system, to hypergeometric system 16 is very difficult. Only some problem of finding solutions. We propose an approach that allow one to find analytic continuation of the Horn's hypergeometric function in the form 15 and find all the functions U and coefficients lambda, where U are solutions to the system 16, to hypergeometric system of partial differential equations. For this purpose, we rewrite the Horn series in the form of 17 that separates the first variable z1. Coefficients t are written explicitly. And here in the formula 17, f is the generalized hypergeometric function of one variable introduced by White in 1930. Then we construct analytic continuation of this function f as follows. We write for this series integral representation as the Mellin-Barnes formula 20. Let us turn to this formula. The function under integral contains two systems of poles. One system in blue points in non-negative integer points, and the other system of poles in green points. The first one lies to the right of the contour of integrating, and the second one lies to the left of the contour of integrating. If we represent this integral in the form of sum of residuals in blue points, we will come to the initial formula 19. And if we represent this integral in the form of sum of residuals in green points, we will come to sum series in negative power of z1. So we find analytic continuation of the function f. But this is only continuation with respect to the variable z1. Then we substitute the result of such continuation into the formula 17. To the formula 17. Change the order of summation. And then we come to the formula 21. This formula reduces the initial function to the some combinations of the series in negative power of z1 and function of Horn type, but with smaller number of variables. Then we successively apply this representation to the Horn series with a smaller number of variables, and so we can try to find the whole analytic continuation of the Horn hypergeometric series. Of course, the problem is somewhat difficult than I have presented. This is only main idea, but next, we will show this approach on the example of the function introduced by Italian mathematician Giuseppe Lauricella in 1894. That is just in the end of the 19th century. This function is the Lauricella function, is defined by the series 22. where z1, etc., zn are complex variables. Are complex variables. A1, etc., an are complex parameters. The series 22 converges in the unit poly disk un. It is necessary to say that this function was introduced as formal generalization of Gaussian hypergeometric function, but then it became to one of the more useful representations of the whole class of multiple hypergeometric functions. Why it is so? It is important to note that for this series, the representation, integral representation 23 is true. This is an Euler type integral representation for this function. We remind that Gaussian hypergeometric function possess the representation 24. These two formulas differ in the number of binomial multipliers in the denominators. The second formula has only one multiplier, and the first formula has n multiplier, just the same as the number of variables of this function. These integrals appear in many applications in quantum mechanics, relativistic physics, etc. Hyperelliptic integrals can be represented in the form of the Lorenzo function just because because this integral representation holds. The Lorenzo function satisfies the system of partial differential equations 25, which is a particular case of the Horn hypergeometric system. This system do not have isolated singular points, but it have singular manifold, which is the union of hyperplanes M, shown in the slide. For example, points with all infinite components or all unit components belong to the singular set for this system. The very beautiful fact that this system has only n plus one linearly independent solution. That is, the holomorphic rank of this system is n plus one. The minimal this is the minimum for hypergeometric very class of hypergeometric system. So the problem for analytic continuation is to find representations 27 where U are some solutions of the system 25 and the lambda are some complex coefficients. We cannot show all these formulas, but the interesting fact that this function is the case when the solution of analytic continuation problem can be solved exhaustively. Let us turn to analysis of one of such formulas. This formula allow one to continue the Lorenzo function into the vicinity of n multiple infinite point. More precisely, into the domain V, which is the domain with some order of modulus of variables z1, etc., zn. The domain like an n multiple cake. The theorem 1 gives representation for the Lorenzo function as the sum of n plus 1 summons, where functions u are placed on the transparency. It should be noted that only the zero function can be expressed in the form of the initial Lorenzo function f.
but with appropriate combinations of parameters and the inverse variable z in -1 power. The other n functions are expressed in term of the series G. This series differs from the initial one, differs from the Lorenzo series, but this series is also belongs to the Horn class of hypergeometric series. Coefficients in representation 13 are expressed in terms of gamma functions, that is as simple as for Gaussian hypergeometric function. We note that if the complex vector argument z lies far enough from the boundary of the domain V, such a representation give an apparatus for effective computation of the Lorenzo function in the domain V, and hence the effective method for computation of such type of integrals, of Euler integrals. I mentioned that we have constructed all the complete system of such formulas that allow one to analytically continue this function into the exterior of the unit poly disk, and hence we have an algorithm for effective computation of the Lorenzo function outside the poly disk, the whole poly disk. Next, we will give some application of these results. There are many applications, but the interesting application is to effective constructing of the conformal mapping of polygonal domains. We remind that the conformal mappings of upper half plane onto polygon can be written in the form of the Schwarz-Christoffel integral 35. This integral is the function of the upper limit. The function on the integral is simple, is the product of some binomials, and this formula would give an explicit analytic apparatus for the computing of this conformal mapping, but the problem is that the parameters z of j are unknown. These parameters are the preimages of the vertices of this polygon. It is well known. It is well known difficult problem to find this parameters. For these unknown quantities, one can write a system of nonlinear equation. This system can be obtained from geometrical representations. If we integrate between the neighboring preimages, take the modulus of these integrals, then we multiply by k, so we can we can find the equations 36, where lk are the lengths of the polygon sides. The problem is difficult because in the just rather simple for the first for the first sight situation, these images, these preimages are placed very unregular. This phenomenon is known as the crowding problem for conformal mapping. Is the crowding problem for the Schwarz-Christoffel integral. Due to the Euler type representation, we can rewrite these integrals in the form of the Lauricella function. The crowding phenomena implies that the variables of such Lauricella functions will be placed outside the unit poly disk. So if we use our formulas for analytic continuation, we can compute such integrals with high precision. This will be demonstrated at the example of the domain, which is a rectangle with two cuts. Such domain is completely defined by lengths of its sides. It has two parameters, epsilon and delta, two small parameters. The parameter delta makes regular perturbation of the domain, and the parameter epsilon makes singular perturbation of the domain. If epsilon is small, then the domain has very narrow isthmus. We will show results when epsilon is 10 to the minus 3 power. We will draw the image of the natural Cartesian mesh using the conformal mapping phi. This mapping is the combination of two mappings, the mapping G and mapping F. Mapping G is just an elliptic function, and mapping F is the Schwarz-Christoffel integral 39. Now we turn to find the parameters of these integrals mu 1, etc., mu 7. We write the system of nonlinear equations for these parameters, where integrals E of K are given by the formula 41, then use the Euler type representation for the Lauricella function, and find these integrals in the form of 33. Next slide shows the arguments of this Lauricella function. For example, let us turn to the argument Z6. If the parameter mu 6 is small, then this variable, the first variable, is very large. So the whole vector lies outside the poly disk, and we need to use the formulas for analytic continuation of the Lauricella function. Now we show the results of our computations. It is easy to see that the parameters mu 1, etc., mu 5 make a crowd. This is the example of crowding phenomenon. Distances between these parameters are very small. You can see the range of this distance is 10 to the minus 15th power, 10 to the minus 11th power. But our formulas of analytic continuation allow us to compute these quantities with high precision, 14 or 15 decimal places. You can see that, namely, the parameter mu 6 is of 10 to the minus 5 power, and so the first quantity is 10 to the 5 power. So if we use analytic continuation formula, then we obtain series in such variables, so we have to compute only several summons of in such formulas, and that is enough for high precision computation. The next slide shows the result of mapping of Cartesian mesh by the mapping phi. in the whole domain, and then we show the zoom near the narrow isthmus. You can evaluate the quantity of this mesh. It should be noted that the singular situation, then the formulas of analytic continuation work effectively. The smaller the parameter, the smaller the distance epsilon, the effective will work these formulas. Thank you for your attention.
So we have time for questions, please.
I have a couple questions. I don't know if time allows. First question.
Yes,
you mentioned.
Time.
Is that working, Mike? That you have algorithm to calculate for this hypergeometric function. What kind of algorithm? Is that symbolic computation or just purely numerical?
Purely numerical, but it can be realized as symbolic algorithm. No matter, I think.
Mm-hmm. And second question in this example on Schwarzkopf's topic. So I guess there are most standard methods just directly calculate without this analytical formula, right? They just need much more.
I think the standard method do not compute what such an example.
So it's impossible, or you just need to go to higher like variable precision?
I didn't try it, but if you make this isthmus shorter, for example, 10 to the minus 4, 10 to the minus 5 power, I think you wouldn't compute this conformal mapping using standard procedures.
Okay, thank you.
You know, one and the same quantities can be computed by different formulas of analytic continuation. If these formulas give the result that coincide with 14, 15 decimal places, we stop this algorithm.
What values do you check?
Values, pre-vertices.
Pre-images,
lengths of the sides, that is the accuracy of the system. And we compare conformal mapping in some other points.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Any more questions?
I'm curious about, we know that there is a Gauss continued fraction for hypergeometric function, which also could be used for analytic continuation as rational approximant. But is there is any hope that for this multivariable hypergeometric function, you could make some sort of algorithm. Do you have some sort of recurrence relation because it's equivalent?
I do not use recurrence relations. They of course exist, but I do not use it. I compute these sums directly.
Do you know works who did it numerically? Is analytic continuation of rational approximants? For
I have seen the works that use this technique, uh-huh. but they didn't use it numerically.
Okay. No. I'm curious about particularly numerical. Okay. If you see it, just tell us. Okay. Thank you.
So any more questions or comments, please.
As I understand, you have a lot of understanding concerning Lauricella case, but you began from task of continuation of in several variables. And have you a general understanding what structure of singular sets has a analytic structure or not?
It is a very difficult problem, and I even do not try to touch this problem.
why only Lauricella? Is it possible to
Of course, it is possible. There is some works, some known works. Many people investigate this question, but I do not work with it. I have find some formulas that is needed in different applications. What and the general approach for the whole class of multiple hypergeometric series.
Okay, so when we have no more questions, then let us